guards stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David, who is the Messiah, the Lord." The angel in each one of these three scenes reassures the recipient of the message that all is okay. They fear that the fear that they have can be safely set aside now so that they can hear and receive the message from God. And God is breaking into the world, into our earthly existence on this day, taking on human flesh, and will be our Savior, our Messiah, and our Lord. Lord, born among the humble and into the most humble of circumstances to fulfill God's promise to bridge the gap between us and God because of our sinfulness. And likewise, in each of these three scenes of the birth narrative of Jesus, Mary, Joseph, and the shepherds all respond in a similar manner. They put their fear aside, they hear and receive the message from God, and they respond in faith to what they've heard. After the angel appears to Mary and tells her not to be afraid, she's able to receive that message from God with a willing heart. And Scripture says, in response to all of that, she tells the angel Gabriel, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." And likewise, when Joseph received his message in the dream, Scripture says he woke from sleep and did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife. And the shepherds, after hearing what the angel had to tell them and listening to the multitude of heavenly hosts singing and praising God, it says the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in a manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had told them. God is not the author of fear. God is the author of hope, eternal hope. God says, "Do not fear. I'm with you. I'm born to you on this day to be your Savior, your Messiah, your Lord." Fear hinders us from hearing the promises of God in our heart, to hear the promises of God in our lives. Fear puts a roadblock in front of us, behind us, and to the sides of us, and prevents us from stepping out in faith. It steals hope and peace from us. It steals hope and peace from our hearts that stretches way beyond our earthly circumstances. Fear robs us of God's hope, peace, and joy. God is not the author of fear. God is the author of hope, eternal hope. We live in an earthly world that feeds on fear. The news and the weather forecasts are sensationalized. We're bombarded with messages and questions that cause us to doubt our abilities, our purpose, our welfare, and that threatens our well-being. As I've heard so often, fear sells. It gets ratings. God is not the author of fear. God is the author of hope, eternal hope. scripture from Luke on this night stand out to me like it never has before. After the shepherds have shared with Mary and Joseph and all who have gathered what they've heard from the angels, scripture says in verse 19, "And Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart." Mary internalized God's message, God's hope and promise that was in her son, because she knew more difficult days would come. And she would need to remind herself and those around her that the darkness of this world doesn't have the final say, folks. And that's the good news. That's the good news I want for you to hear tonight with every fiber of your being. And God broke into this world for us so that we're not overtaken by the darkness of this world, but rather that we are liberated by the love of God in the way that is life-changing. So when you find yourself wrestling with fear and doubt and uncertainty, hear God's messenger speaking through the power of the Holy Spirit. Don't be afraid. God, I am with you. I bring you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day the Savior, the Messiah, the Lord. And like Mary, treasure those words and keep them close to your heart. Because undoubtedly you and I will need them over and over again as we make our journey through the challenges of this earthly life. God is the author of hope, eternal hope.